everyone, in today's video we're gonna talk about CryptoDrakeBall. This game is kinda famous in the NFTs, in the NFT community, NFT games. So that's the website, one of the websites. And first of all, we're gonna start of course with SimilarWeb. There's the 5.3 monthly visits, that's really good. You can see the global rank, category rank, and from where people are playing: United States, China, Philippines. Okay, let's start with the game. So CryptoDrakeBall is a play to earn NFT RPG developed on the Binance Smart Chain platform. The game revolves around the acquisition, I'm not sure about this word, of legendary dragon and powerful heroes to training them. Players may take part in arena using their assets to earn DBALL tokens. Assets are player owned NFTs mint in the ERC-721 standard, which may be traded on the proprietary marketplace. Tokenomics. Okay, total supply, I think that's 1 million. Gameplay incentives, 2 million. Liquidity, 1.5 million. Locked development, same, locked for 12 months. Liquidity farming incentives, 1 million. Airdrops, private sale, public are finished. So, roadmap. Roadmap phase 1 has completed successfully. Many thanks for our community support. We will never stop developing. More new features and great universe are coming in phase 2. Let's wait for CryptoDrakeBall comeback for you. Phase 1 was... So the phase 1 is completely done, but there was a graphic design character and marketplace, launch social plus website, audit contact by tech audit, marketing, private sales, public sale, airdrop, LP added on pancake, public launch NFT battle, influencer marketing, public launch NFT marketplace, CoinGecko coin market listing. Phase 2. Public launch the room of spirit and time, influencers marketing, release more DrakeBall NFT characters, gathering and upgrading Drake clothes, features release, expanding team, game studio partnerships explained, expanded. So phase 2 is also complete. As we can see, I'm not completely sure, probably they will add something, so it's not complete, but those one are completed. Phase 3 coming soon in October 2021. Okay, good roadmap. Coming soon in October. So, gameplay. CryptoDrakeBall exploits a play to earn model by using DBALL to gameplay and giving value to players' NFTs by increasing their use to future features. NFTs may be freely traded on the marketplace for DBALL tokens, which can then be traded on exchanges or converted to fiat currency. Does the characters from 1 star to 6 stars? Currently, the following options are available for players to earn: participating in a fight through the use of heroes and Drake clothes equipped NFTs for DBALL. So, we need clothes equipped. Okay. Capsuling characters, gathering Drake clothes as and selling them for DBALL on the marketplace, trading NFTs with other players for BEP20 tokens, exchanging DBALL on a DEX for currency that can be traded on an exchange such as Binance. Adventure mode. How to play CryptoDrakeBall in new update map. We have seen 3 options appear on the map at the opening: Arena, Drake Claw, Namek Defense. I'll show you this one in a bit. Each map has its own requirement. For example, you need clothes in Claw map and armor at Namek. Oh, there's an armor for here, low for here. Yeah. On the arena stage, we still can join in the battle with the characters only, without item required. But the reward now is significantly dropped, and there will be no bonus. So there's a. Does your character level 2, and does the enemies. You will gain like a half DBALL. The price of DBALL now is $1.50, so 75 cents, something like that, for this one. And there's a 50% win rate. In this one, 30% win rate, but you can win up to 1 DBALL. And experience, of course, okay. That's his two characters. Drake Claws. In the Drake Claws stage, we may equip our warrior with an item called Claw to increase his strength and get more rewards. Please keep in mind that there is no limit to the number of claws that can be equipped for one hero. For example, you have one claw and can get 0.8 in the bull fight. If you select 10 claws at once and get 1.8 in the bull fight, and it costs you only the stamina of the character. So it's as many as much claw you have is better. Here's what happened when you use hero rare 1 combined with 2 claw rare 6 weapons to fight an enemy that has a 90% chance to winning 1 DBALL. That's good. Namek Defense. In the Namek Defense level, players need armor type item to participate in the plan in this planet. Only armor type items is allowed here. If you does not own the armor item, you cannot get in a fight here. The price of armor will also be different, and the bonus reward will also be higher than claw. User can choose multiple armor equipped for their warriors and fight at once. It's the same rule as claw, only 3 stamina of character each fight, but x 10 rewards if you choose 10 armors. Probably armors will be the expensive one from the two. Important note, the number of warriors is limited to 4, at most 4, but the number of items is infinity. As a result, players may make the most of their stamina when using combined as much as equipment to battle. For example, one warrior combined with 3, 4 or more items to combat at once. Fighting in arena. Fights are on-chain transaction that takes the power values of the chosen character and chosen enemy and compares the calculator rolls to determine if the player wins or loses. Fighting in arena. Combat service as the primary source for achieving DBALL through the use of your Drake Claws NFTs and characters. Combat consists of the player choosing a hero and a Drake Claws if this feature released, and selecting enemies from a random group based on your power calculation system. After the player has chosen their enemy, the contract calculates your odds of winning against the opponent. There's a 4 options to choose enemies with different win rate and different rewards. There will be with 90% rate, 70% rate, 50% rate, and 30% rate. You can see them here. With less percent rate, there will be more DBALL. A winning battle will pay your character experience bonus and DBALL reward to your wallet. The lower the win rate, the higher the reward. A loss result in a loss of gas fee paid. Okay, you need to pay gas fee also. Capsuling characters. Characters are one of the two main NFTs currency available in CryptoDrakeBall. Characters are necessary to fight in arena in CryptoDrakeBall, and only grow in value as the gamer continues to fight. The price to capsule characters is displayed on a button in the capsule tab. All the bull spent on capsuling characters gets sent to the contract that handles fight payouts. Each character starts at level 1 and comes with a random star rarity upon capsuling. Currently, there is no way to change the rarity of a character. CDC stands for CryptoDrakeBall character, and are the character NFTs present on your wallet. CDC stands for CryptoDrakeBall items, CDI, and are the items NFTs present on your wallet. Each item will have three different packages: standard, premium, luxury. The higher price, higher profit per battle for each item. All items can be cumulative when equipped your character to fight in arena. You're saving gas fee each fight, so you can maximize profits each fight by owning several items at the same time. Character levels. Each character starts at level 1, requiring experience gained in successful combat to increase. The rarity as well as the level of the character during combat will determine the DBALL rewards of victories. About the opening rate of rare characters as well as the XP to level up the reward for each battle, please refer to the project's white paper on website. That's the XP table. Level 1, you need 800 XP. You can check it by yourself, and from the last level, probably it's level 62, 5400. Next, stamina. Each character has their own individual stamina, which is 4 times fighting maximum. One turn fight cooldown is 3 hours, and one character can charge fully at 8 turns fight day. This means that in 24 hours, each character can get 8 times fighting in the arena with every 3 hours waiting. That was really important to know that. And I want to say something before continue. If you like the video, make sure to like the comment down below, subscribe to my channel, check my referral links in the description. You will help the channel a lot with this one. So I really appreciate your time. So let's continue now. Trading and marketplace. Trading. Players may trade their NFTs on the marketplace for DBALL. Players may also conduct peer-to-peer trades through the use of the NFT contracts. Marketplace. Currently you can find the marketplace. I'll show you the marketplace now. Marketplace, that's the other site where you will play the game. So that's the, you have armor and claw. Claw, rarity, armor and rarity. So the cheapest one, armor, is was that 7-8 DBALL, let's say. But no, right, okay, let's see the last one, 4.5 DBALL. That's like $5 or something, probably $5-6 for armor. But the rare one, the most expensive one, is 60 DBALL. And for claw, let's start with the rarity one. Rarity one, you have there's a pages, lowest 2 DBALL. So that's a good price, probably less than 1 DBALL, like $1.50. And the most expensive one, 500. Those two, but no, yeah, probably, I'm not sure about the statistics of those one, but there's 50 DBALL, 35, 40, you can check it by your own. And I want to show you, I'm not completely sure about this one, but probably from here you can capsule the character. I'm not playing the game, so I'm just reviewing it, but in the future probably I can invest some money and show you something, some things. So if you like the video, like and comment down below, so I can do that for you. And now if you want to capsule, just click here, and as you can see, there's a gas fee. I'm not completely sure, transaction fee I mean, but I'm not sure about other fees. And so that's the price, $75 for a one character, probably. Not completely sure, I can't tell you that, but looks like. And he does the map. You can get a claw, like to mine the claw, but the price is not good at all, so just buy it from the marketplace. Okay, let's continue. Marketplace, you saw it. DrakeBall New World. Okay, the old planet has been destroyed by the DrakeBall warriors. Never-ending wars with alien invaders from another galaxy. The enemy is likewise making their way out of this area. To replace the wrecked planet, the warriors must venture out into the wider world in quest of the of new habitations. So it looks really cool if does the artworks and everything. Huh. Looks really really cool. And that's the future of the game. The DrakeBall warriors must become even more powerful than before in order to cross the huge chasm of universes. That's why they decide to merge them. When two warriors combine forces, they become one powerful warrior. Super warriors are the label given to these particular types of warriors. Planet S was the first place they discovered in the far reaches of the universe. This region is teeming with life and resources in abundance. The adversary, on the other hand, was quicker when they established a colony on Planet S. As a result of their battles with these enemies, the super warriors begin on a mission to save the globe. Cool story. Gameplay. So that's the gameplay, probably. I'm not sure if this one is released. But as you can see, the website is just like that. So you can check it by your own. We have a universe, how to get character on S planet. Oh, so this one. NFT. You need to have NFT. And pay something. DBALL will always be used every time you pair a character to a new planet. Lands this DBALL will be burned immediately, causing the total supply of DBALL to decrease day by day. For SBALL, in the fusion recipe, it will be transferred to the SNFT Warrior Reward Wallet. SNFT character from Planet S will be used to play and earn SBALL tokens. Each SNFT will have a different power base. The higher the rarity, the stronger the power base, the more SBALL will earn. The rarity of the character on Planet D used for fusion will determine the rarity of the SNFT. For example, you have 1D NFT rare 1 paired with 1D NFT rare 6 will produce an SNFT around rare 4. So that was the main thing. Let's see characters. That's the characters. Twin Drake, Omega Drake, Gouken, Android 17, Android 18, Forgotten Drake, Majin Drake, Sanzuma, Rat Drake, Eat, Black Gouken, and Daishin. And there was a raid. Oh, this one just changed the color and names of the characters. Okay. Godfather. and stamina. Stamina is required for the character to participate in the battle in arena on planet S. Stamina does not replenish on its own. To manufacture stamina beans, the player must visit the practice room. There will be a wide range of practice rooms, each with its own set of requirements, as well as varying amounts of time and effectiveness. That's the rooms, that's the beans. Room 1. Senzu bean. If you want to practice passing in room 1, you must have holding S-Ball BNB LP liquidity point in your wallet. The quality of the beans in this area will be higher, plus more stamina. To know how to add liquidity, read that's the some kind of document. Room 2. Unknown bean. A free practice room is available in room 2. To find out how successful a bean is, players will have to feed SNFT while training an unknown amount of stamina into the bean. Room 3. The third room is a no-cost practice area. The user will be able to create a wide range of new beans, all of which will have different effects on the character. The trained beans in this room in contrast to those in room 2 immediately display usable or unusable stats. Random bean. Room 4, super bean. Room 4 is a no-cost practice area. In order to train a huge bean, players must spend a lot of time in. And room 5. Mini bean. Room 5, which is a free practice room, modest beans, mini, can be trained with a small amount of stamina and extra yet brief training time by players. All 5 of the game's bean training rooms can be used at the same time by players. After completing the training, players can use the beans they've earned to feed and replenish their character's health so they can keep fighting. The more matches a player can play, the higher their level will be and the greater their power will be as they collect stamina. There is a daily reward cup of S-Bulls that can be received by each S-NFT. The more you level up, the more battles you need to win to get the best reward. There's a couple more trading in marketplace. At the same time, we are expanding the multiverse market. The multiverse marketplace account accepts all NFTs, DNFT, SNFT, and NFT. NFT characters from all machines. We will create the interplanetary portal after all of the maps are unlocked. For example, the switch port can be configured to convert the kind of token S-Ball to DBALL in a specific ratio. As a result, DBALL will remain the game's principal token and any transaction or fusion NFT will be linked to DBALL. Because of the perceived active fusion technology used by DBALL, the token's price is avoid less likely to see a perception decline. That's the marketplace. What is DBALL? DBALL serves as the native currency for CryptoDrakeBall. Players use DBALL to capsule characters, gathering and upgrading dragon claws, and to buy and sell on the CryptoDrakeBall marketplace. There is a maximum supply of 1 million DBALL tokens. Liquidity will be locked and the development fund will be vested at the rate of 25% return per quarter. Total supply 1 million. Gameplay incentives 200. Every transaction include capsuling character, buy, sell DBALL. Slippage fee will be returned to this fund. Liquidity 150,000 locked LP. Development 150. Vest at a rate of 10% per month. Distributed 10% at the first month. Liquidity farming incentives 100,000. Airdrops 50,000 locked for 2 weeks. Private sale 200,000 completed. public, 150,000 completed. And there's a how to buy DBALL on PancakeSwap. Create a cryptocurrency wallet, set up and deposit funds into the wallet like MetaMask. I use MetaMask as well. Add funds for the gas fees. To use BCC, you need to purchase a small amount of Binance coin, BNB, to use for gas fee. Do it only with BNB. Don't mess around with other tokens. BNB is good. Connect your wallet to PancakeSwap. Connect your wallet to PancakeSwap by clicking connect. Okay. Click select, search DBALL token. If you can't find it, put the contract. That's the contract on DBALL token. Review setting. I'll put this one down below in the description. Review settings. You can change the specification of the trade, such as slippage, tolerance, and transaction deadlines. Once you finish setting the number of tokens you're buying, swap, finally press the approve button, confirm the transaction. This will result in a pop-up reviewing the overall asset transfer on your wallet. Once approved, hit the swap button, Pancake, a new transaction is completed. You can now purchase your character items with your DBALL. Yes, this one. So that was really important. As you can see, as I say, I'll put this one down in the description. Vision. Our vision is for players to take control of their digital assets, play to earn, and increase implementation of blockchain technology in their daily life. Mission. Our mission is to provide a fun and profitable experience for our gamers, to create a healthy and excited community. Around blockchain, gaming can build an ecosystem of play-to-earn system to meet their needs of all gamers from around the world. Last one, the contracts. After we mint enough coins, according to our tokenomic, we have locked all mined function by the new contract. The transaction of mined function announced here, please carefully check. The new contract name, DBALL config contract, contract token DBALL, contract NFT DBALL, contract battle reward, migration. Oh, that's the contract of the, if you need this one, go on the website and check it. That was the, that was the game. You can stake, but it's coming soon. You can farm. There's a lot of things you can check. Be sure to make your own research. Don't believe to people on internet. And that's the price by now. As you can see, there was a highs and downs, up and downs. So make your own research. Now is not the best time to join the game, but if you believe in the game, it can grow. Looks stable or something. Yeah, it's kind of stable right now. So make your own research, check it by yourself, join the community, join their chats and profiles, follow them. You can see the market cap here. Okay, there's no trading volume, everything is here. That's good. So thank you for the time. Be sure to learn new things every day, and see you soon.